Malaysia is likely to continue with an expansionary budget next year to support economic growth, but a long-term solution is needed to enhance revenue sources.
Prime Minister Anwar Ibrahim is expected to announce more initiatives to woo high-tech investment in his budget announcement on Friday. Minister Goh takes a look at how Malaysia plans to stay competitive.
Prime Minister Anwar Ibrahim is on a mission to prepare the country for the next economic takeoff. Since he came to power last November, Mr. Anwar has been the country's number one salesman, wooing global investors to invest in high-growth, high-value sectors. So far, he's made two trips to China, where some $40 billion worth of deals and MOUs were signed. He also announced global semiconductor giant Infineon's $5.3 billion investment, as well as Tesla's plan to set up a headquarters in Malaysia. Economic Affairs Minister Rafizi Ramli believes that the country is on track to develop high-value strategic industries that are capable of stimulating investment and offering high-paying jobs.
Despite all these global challenges, you know, and economic headwinds, there is a lot of interest among investors to come and participate in our new growth narrative. So what we are expecting is to go through the short-term challenges in the next 6 months, 9 months, and build the foundation for these high-growth, high-value sectors that can bring in new kind of investments in the next 2 years.
Under the Madani growth narrative, Malaysia aims to become the world's top 30 largest economy by 2030 and top 12 in terms of ease of doing business. Now, industry experts, while lauded the ambitious plans, cautioned that various government agencies must adopt an integrated approach.
The Prime Minister goes in and sees these big corporations in the US and nobody follows up. It's also a waste of time. If you go and deal with the Chinese investors, also make a whole bunch of MOUs and nobody follows up and it doesn't get delivered, it's also a waste of effort. So you've got to deliver after the door has been opened by the Prime Minister.
And more, he said, needs to be done as building the right ecosystem takes time.
I think the transition is going to be challenging, simply because it means massive amounts of productivity now need to go into the workforce. Even simple things like public holidays, you know, how many public holidays impact productivity? These kind of things will need to be rationalized and understood in the context of global competitiveness.
Many industry players have called for greater efficiency in public delivery system by removing red tape and overlap.
I think you have 7, 8, 9 agencies approving it. So even if all 7, 8 of them are business friendly, the process of getting the 7 to approve it also takes time. So I think that is the last mile and you need to correct that as well.
Political stability is key to implementing complex economic strategies. And Prime Minister Anwar Ibrahim, who's also the finance minister, won't be able to cut it without the support of both the public and private sectors. Melissa Goh, CNA, Kuala Lumpur.